So 2 days ago, I was scrolling through Twitter, minding my own business. I wasn't necessarily looking for anything that can be, for a topic for a video, until something caught my attention, and it had something to do with the state that I'm from, which is Alabama. If you haven't heard the news, what's going on in Alabama right now, let me go ahead and tell you. And I'm reading a news article from CBS, and the title of the article, which should catch a lot of attention here, is Alabama Senate votes to make hormone therapy and surgery for trans youth a felony. So let me go ahead and read the article for you so you can have an understanding of what's going on with the situation. Under a new law, transgender youth in Alabama could not be treated with puberty blockers, hormone therapy, or surgery. The state Senate voted to make the treatment a felony on Tuesday. Senators voted 23-4 to approve the measure, dubbed the Vulnerable Child Compassion and Protection Act, sponsored by Republican Senator Shay Schnault. Can't fucking pronounce that, my apology. The bill now heads to the State House of Representatives, which has already approved a companion bill. The two bills would make it a felony for medical professionals to treat transgender minors under the age of 19 with gender-affirming care. Violators could face up to 10 years in prison or a $15,000 fine. The bill also requires school staff in the state to disclose to parents that a minor's perception of his or her gender is inconsistent with his or her sex. Essentially, teachers would be required to out transgender students to their guardians, regardless of whether they are ready to do so. Children aren't mature enough to make these decisions on surgeries and drugs, Schnault told the Associated Press. The whole point is to protect kids. While similar measures have been considered across the country, Alabama would be the first state to pass such a bill. Parents, members of the transgender communities, and medical experts opposed to the bill say that it's dangerous, and the lawmakers do not understand the already difficult process to receive gender-affirming care. The article does go on, but I'm going to go ahead and cut it off right there. If you want to read it for yourself, I will leave a link to the article in the description of this video. Now that you know the basics of what's going on in Alabama and what they're wanting to pass, let me go ahead and give you my opinion of the situation. And it might not be popular, you know, but it's my opinion and I have to stand up for it. So, but before I, you know, give my positives, the things that I think that are going right for this bill, let me go ahead and tell you the things that are going wrong for this bill and what ultimately makes the bill wrong in general. And that's the part where the bill requires basically public school teachers to out, as it says in the article, to out trans kids to their parents. I think that is just 100%, without a doubt, wrong. That right there is irresponsible. All right, like, you don't know what's going on in the family, right? So what you could be doing right now is setting off a fucking bomb, all right? And especially for kids who don't want to be known that they're trans, or just, you know, they're still trying to go through the motions, just, you know, still trying to figure it out, and to have someone to literally go to your parents and be like, hey, your kid's fucking trans, there's something wrong with your kid, or something like that. You know, this is basically witch hunting. You know, this is basically witch hunting. This bill wants teachers to witch hunt trans kids. And again, like, the suicide rate among, you know, the trans kids, it's high, right? It's high. This would inevitably make things higher. That point right there, that part of the bill, I believe, is the thing that will break the camel's back, that will make the bill not work, that will make everything backfire, literally backfire, on the state and on the people. Now, the thing that I agree with the bill is essentially the age requirement that someone needs to be, which is the age of 19, to go through puberty blockers, hormone therapy, or surgery. I agree with that entirely. I don't think that kids should have the ability to go through these serious things, these serious decisions, at such a young age. You know, I just think that's extremely irresponsible. There's, you know, reasons why we don't let kids vote. We don't let them drink. You know, you have to be 18 to vote. You have to be 21 to vote. Ironically, you can be 18 and, you know, be ready to serve your country. And yeah, there are problems with that. But to say that a child, a five-year-old kid, can go through, surgery to remove his genitals and replace it for something else, or to get puberty blockers at an age of, you know, at 9 or 10, I think is just highly, highly irresponsible. In my opinion, I think it's extremely irresponsible. They should not have the ability to do that. I think it also can be abused as well. If you don't remember a situation, I think that happened maybe a year ago, maybe 2 years ago. There was a child by the name of James Younger. I think it was Younger or Young, but his mother was attempting to manipulate the kid, right, the boy, to think that he was actually a girl, that he was, you know, trans. Now, with that being said, she wanted her son to go through puberty blockers. She also wanted him, I believe, to go through a surgery to, you know, to change things here and there. And obviously, the father wasn't having it. He was just like, no, that's just fucked. That's literally fucked up. And so, you know, they went through a thing. I think he won in the end, so I'm glad with that. But I genuinely think that there should be a limit. There should be an age limit to where someone can do things like this, where they can alter their body, because I don't think a child would be able to make a conscious decision like this appropriately. Now, here's the deal, though. If you ask me, Rigozen, would you vote on this bill to pass? No, I would not. I was thinking about it today, and I was only thinking about, like, oh, I think this is good and shit like that. But now that I'm thinking about it today, as I'm making this video, or actually before making this video, no, I would legitimately not vote for the bill. And why would I not vote for the bill? For the simple part of outing out trans kids. That, again, will blow up in their fucking faces. It's not going to end very well. Now, if it wasn't because of that, then I would vote for it. I definitely do agree that there should be an age limit to where someone can, you know, alter their body. Because that shit's serious. That shit isn't child's play, right? That is legitimately serious. Once you go forward, I would imagine you can't go back. So, yes, you have to be 19. I am a firm believer. But for the simple fact that they are trying to out trans kids of their parents in this bill, I can't. I really can't vote for it. I can't agree with it, because it's just gonna end very badly for everyone in the situation. But that's basically the entire situation, my thoughts and feelings about it. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section down below. If you wanna discuss with me, if you wanna argue with me, again, not necessarily in the comment section, hit me up in Discord. If you wanna be more personal, hit me up in Discord. That'll be fine, that'll be all right. But again, thank you everyone for watching the video. I really do appreciate it. If you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button. If you wanna see more content like this, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell notification to be notified on my next video. But until then, ladies and gentlemen, I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye for now, and stay safe out there.